afternoon, Uncle John.
We just here handling your business. Enjoy yourself, and I love you.
Excuse me.
John, I just want to say I'm very proud of you. You deserve this. Nothing but better and bigger things coming for you. Love you.
Take care of it.
Poppy.
Thank you so
congratulations.
Much.
And
you
get
to validated.
That's how you doing.
Yeah, here's with mine.
All right.
Thank you. Oh, Uncle John, I wish you nothing but blessings and success in your future endeavors. Love you, niece Christine.
How you doing, Uncle John? It's your favorite nephew, Mike. Enjoy yourself and live life. Love you.
What's one guest with me?
Hi, my love. I'm so proud of you, and I really, truly hope you've enjoyed this evening. And new expectations is what we expect of you, and we know you will fulfill all of our dreams, as you always have. I love you so much.
I'm very proud, brother. Very happy to be here, and I'm most proud of my son. John.
John, you've been an absolute inspiration as far as I'm concerned. You've been a mentor to me, and sorry to see you go, but I'm sure that you're going to go on to some bigger, better things. I love you, and wish you well.
Good luck on your new endeavors.
John, I'm Jackie. Words really can't express what you mean to me. You've been there really since before I was born. You're my parents, best friends in the whole wide world. Your son, bruh, is one of my best friends in the whole wide world. Really more like a brother to me. All that you've accomplished, I can only wish that I could come close to being there. Being here tonight is something that I can only hope and dream for, to be that thought of in the same breath, same essence as you are. You're wonderful people, and a true inspiration to Cape Verdean people, African American people all across the world. I love you, and I hope to spend more and more time with you throughout my life, you're there for me when I went through a trying time over the summer, when I was on my deathbed, you were the first people I woke up to, and I love you more than words can express, honestly. Thank you so much for everything.
Thank you.
It's my pleasure to welcome you tonight. I'm going to ask Mrs. Jacqueline A. Ramos to please come to the podium.
Hello, it's my honor and pleasure to say welcome, welcome, welcome. My husband always started with this adage about everybody used to say, it's Bridgeport, what do you expect? And his philosophy was to start changing that whole persona and say, it's Bridgeport, expect great things. And he has done all he could to try to make all of that happen. And I truly believe that he has made a positive impact on our students and the community. I just want to say welcome. I am so thrilled you're all here. And for those of you who don't know me, because my husband would not let me go to the board meeting, he would not let me write anything in the paper. I do exist. I'm Mrs. Ramos, and I am so pleased you're all here again. We are going to have a good time because we know we call this new expectations, because there is going to be change within our immediate family and our immediate life. But we know, with the grace of God, everything is going to be good. I have to share something with you. Our daughter, Dakara, who lives in Atlanta, was not able to attend. And she asked me to read this. Is my husband here? Okay, this is from my daughter, Dakara. She's dying. Hey, Mom, thank you so much for reading this for me. Please begin by telling everyone how incredibly sad I am when I'm not. Dad, I've been with you from the beginning. Since the days when you would go to school during the day and pump gas all night, barely having time to study, let alone sleep. Meanwhile, you had a screaming baby at home to contend with. How you were able to get through 4 years of college that way is mystifying, but you stuck it out for us. Yes, I've been with you from the beginning. Over the years, our family has had its fair share of ups and downs, but the one thing that has never wavered is your faith in God. If I put God first in my life and in all of my pursuits, everything will work out. That is the greatest lesson I learned from you. I only have one issue with you. Set the bar way too high for any man I date. They say a girl wants to marry someone like her dad. But where on earth will I find a loving, honest, educated, handsome, God-fearing family man? I'm doomed. Seriously, to say that I am proud of you and me, that would be an understatement. I am exceedingly proud of your professional and service accomplishments, but that doesn't define you. It barely scratches the surface. What I am most proud of is that you are a man of principle and a man of faith. I love you so much, Dad. May God continue to bless you and guide your footsteps. Love, Doover Doover. Keep it over. Again, welcome, and we are going to party. I even learned how to do the wobble yesterday, so get ready.
We're all set for our next celebrity speaker, our guest speaker. This man does not need an introduction. Everybody knows our mayor of the city of Bridgeport, Mayor Bill Finch. Yeah.
Where's John? Oh, there he is. It's really an honor and privilege to be here for you tonight, John. We have, I think, arguably been through the most difficult time that any mayor and any superintendent had to go through, certainly in my recollection. Maybe since a mayor arrested all the teachers have we not had those the challenges that we've had. And I want to tell you that the mark of any good relationship is that you can agree to disagree. And one of the most important things to me is truthfulness, honesty, and loyalty in politics. And like it or not, a superintendent is a very political position. And if you have someone who is loyal in the big sense, loyal to the children, you know you have a gem. And we have a gem in John Ramos. In a way, I wish I didn't have to say this, but in modern times it's very rare that mayors send their children to Bridgeport Public Schools. It's wrong, they should, and I do. And I do because I believe in the public schools, and I believe in John Ramos, and I believe in what he has been trying to do for our children in the city of Bridgeport. And we all know that there have been four lawsuits as to the constitutionality of the funding formula for children in the state of Connecticut. And there are some state representatives here, and there are some state senators here. I see Representative Morrison from Norwalk is here. I want to thank him for being here. Lewis, always good to see you. I know that Representative Grogans is here, Auden Grogans, who was the chairman of the board. Auden, where are you? Auden? And I have had many conversations about Superintendent Ramos because she really worked closer with him than any politician, I think, in Bridgeport. But we have had Horton versus Meskill. We have had Johnson versus Rowland. We have had Sheff versus O'Neill. And now we have CJF versus Rel. And someday, I'm not sure what it is, but I do believe it will happen. Someday we'll be able to get up in the morning and look in the mirror and say the children of Bridgeport are treated equally. It isn't yet. It isn't yet. But someday, because of people like John, it will happen. It will happen. Whereas Dr. John Ramos has served as superintendent of Bridgeport Public Schools since June of 2005, under his leadership, the school district and supporting community developed and continue to pursue an aggressive strategic plan that endorses the focused mission to graduate all students college-ready and prepared to succeed in life. Expect great things. It was stolen by Kohl's department store, I hope you know that. Because right after John coined it, I went in there and I saw it after he coined it. So somebody made a lot of money off of your saying. And we won the Broad Prize. We were a finalist in 2006 and 2007. We actually didn't win it, but we were right there. And I want to thank you for that, because nationally it put Bridgeport on the map. Whereas prior to serving as superintendent of schools in Bridgeport, Dr. Ramos was deputy commissioner of education programs and services for the Connecticut State Department of Education. His responsibilities include assisting school districts in raising student achievement, closing achievement gaps, and facilitating high school reform. And whereas Dr. Ramos served Watertown Public Schools as superintendent from 2002 to 2004, under his leadership, a fractured board, sorry, is that right, a fractured board? Nothing fractured like you dealt with here, John. A fractured board, the school district and the community were brought together. Watertown Public School Education Foundation was established, and the district was awarded the highly competitive four-year instructional improvement grant from the Connecticut Center for School Change. Whereas Dr. Ramos has served as assistant superintendent for curriculum and instruction for Norwalk Public Schools, principal of Norwalk High School, principal director for the Providence School District's Alternate Education Learning Project High School, director of Minority Student Affairs at the University of Rhode Island, and program director for Rhode Island Department of Education. And whereas Dr. Ramos received a doctorate in education administration from Columbia University, his MBA from the University of Rhode Island, a bachelor's degree in English and American literature from Brown University, Dr. Ramos was awarded the Dr. Martin Luther King International Award by the State of Israel and Ethics and in Action Award by the Connecticut School of Ethical Education in 2010. Now, therefore, I, Bill Finch, Mayor of the City of Bridgeport, declare today as John Ramos Sr., ED, D-Day, in the great city of Bridgeport. Congratulations, John. If I could just say one more thing about you, John. I have a traveling mic. I kind of feel like Oprah over here. I want to thank you personally for what you've done for my two kids, because you started a little speaker program, put the speakers in the corners of the room, and you can't get the speaker out of my kid's hand when he has one, or any of the kids in the class, and they all can hear it much better. But I want to just say, we built one of the greenest schools in the state, the Discovery Magnet School, because of John, and it's a regional school, and there's a waiting list of white suburbanites who want to come to school with our kids in Bridgeport. And that is a critical, critical thing. And he didn't rest on his laurels after that, because then he said, we've got to build something even bigger and greener and even more transformative. And despite the fact that there were people that tried to stop John and tried to stop the city for building the Fairchild Wheeler Memorial High School, the Fairchild Wheeler Regional High School, you stuck with it, and because of that, 1,000 kids from now until we're long gone are going to be in a transformative school, an integrated school, and a great science magnet, and I really thank you for that. You're a great guy. You're a remarkable teacher of the city of Bridgeport for a long, long, long time.
With our program. Next is a presentation and resolution by Dr. Elizabeth Fieser. She's the first Vice President of CAPS, the Connecticut Association of Public School Superintendents. Dr. Fieser, welcome and thank you.
Good evening, everyone. First of all, it's a real privilege to be here and to be able to present this award on behalf of the Connecticut Association of Public School Superintendents. But before I do the resolution from the CAPS organization, I just would like to say a few remarks to John. I know John personally. I know John going back to Norwalk when he was a high school principal. I know John when he became assistant superintendent in Norwalk, when he then went to Watertown, and then to Bridgeport. I tried to talk him out of going to Bridgeport. Forgive me, but I did, as a friend. But anyways, my mother, when I was growing up in the Midwest, she used to talk rarely about individuals, and she would describe them as the salt of the earth, which most of you know is from the scriptures. And growing up, I never quite knew what that meant. I always had a sense of, you know, what is she talking about? Till I became an adult, and then there's been some people in my life that I have met that I now know that if my mother were to meet them, would say, he's the salt of the earth. And John, you're one of those people. There's no finer an individual that I've had the privilege of meeting in my career than you, John, on a personal level. You are one of the most humble, fine, good men, leaders, educators that I've ever had the privilege of knowing. You focus continually on doing right by kids when many of us get detoured, but you don't get detoured. Always, 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 even about kids. And every single time I have been in your presence, I am centered again and what we should be about as human beings and what we should be about as educators. And for that, I thank you. It has been an honor, a privilege, and a blessing to have you as part of my life. school superintendents. Whereas Dr. John Ramos, some of this you've heard, but I'm going to read it again because he's had an extraordinary life. Has served in Bridgeport with distinction as the superintendent of schools since 2005. Prior to Bridgeport, he served as Deputy Commissioner of Education Programs at the Connecticut State Department of Education from 2004 to 2005. He served as superintendent in Watertown from 2002 to 2004, as assistant superintendent for curriculum and instruction in Norwalk from 2000 to 2002, from principal of Norwalk High School from 1989 to 2000, and as principal director of the Alternative Learning Project High School in Providence, Rhode Island from 1983 to 1989. And whereas he began his educational career as program developer and director with the Rhode Island Department of Providence from 1980 to 1982, and was the director of minority student affairs with the University of Rhode Island in Kingston, Rhode Island from 1982 to 1983. He has been a loyal and active member of the Connecticut Association of Public School Superintendents. And with an exemplary degree of professional knowledge and organizational skill, he has, by his own conscientious diligence and boundless energy, set a good example to all who worked with him. He has withstood the challenges and faced the occupational hazards presented by the modern day superintendency, basing his decisions and positions on considered professional principle rather than on expediency or popularity. And his genuine concern for others and his ever-present good nature have earned him the respect of all with whom he has come in contact. So whereas Dr. John Ramos has truly made a difference in the lives of children, youth, and adult learners that he has served, be it resolved that he be most highly honored and most highly commended for his many years of devoted service to education, and that he be thanked by his colleagues and staff for his constant and consistent encouragement and leadership, and signed by Judith Palmer, who is the president of the organization, and Dr. Joe Cirasolo, executive director of CAPS.
And now we're going to continue with blessings from Reverend Samuel Dexter, senior minister of the First Congregational United Church of Christ in Watertown, Connecticut.
Good evening. It is such a privilege for me, as John and Jackie's pastor in Watertown, to be here this evening with all of you to provide our blessing, to ask God's blessing over this gathering tonight. Because John, you are a blessing, and I just want to let you know what a blessing that you have been for me, and what an inspiration. I know that as a pastor, it's my job to inspire you, but right back at you, because there's been many a Sunday where I've heard myself sharing my own reflections about the costs and joy of following in the way of our Savior, and I've looked down, and I hope that those words have been helpful and inspiring for you in your journey, because you embody what we all preach and share together in the way of our Savior.
Okay, our next guest speaker has a long resume. The best way that I can summarize this is that he's a retired president and CEO of Bridgeport Hospital. So I'd like to introduce to you our chairman of the Bridgeport Board of Education, Mr. Robert Trefry.
Thank you, sir. You've heard from a lot of speakers tonight when they were reading their proclamations about all the wonderful things that Dr. Ramos has accomplished. I'm not going to try to repeat that. There was only one that I think it bears repeating, and that's the being the finalist in the Brode Prize twice. That is a national accomplishment. That's not a state accomplishment. It's not a regional accomplishment. It's a national accomplishment. And when that happened, I think one could easily say, and should say, that that was in the face of all odds. That this is his friend counseled him about coming to Bridgeport if you look at this Bridgeport schools and the underfunding and the challenges that exist there, this was something that was not done easily. This was something that was done with great determination, and it was done in the face of the odds being against you. Many times when we leave a position and people look back, sometimes they think about the things that we've accomplished. But more times they think about the people that we were. And I think if I think about John, the word gentleman is the thing that always comes to my mind. He personifies what I would say is the real gentleman. A person who is respectful, a person who is kind, a person who wants to know other people. And also a person who is concerned about others. Not always himself. He's concerned about others more than himself. He is concerned about the students in the schools. He's concerned about everyone in this community, and he's concerned about the people that he works with. John is a product of Bridgeport. He is a person who grew up here and came back to do some great things, and he has done some great things in the city. He's done some great things in education and for the students of this town. We thank him for that tremendously. Now, we wish you Godspeed. We know that you will expect great things of us, and we expect great things of you.
I'm going to ask our former mayor of the city of Bridgeport, Mr. John Fabrizi, to come up to the podium and address you with a letter that was sent to me on Friday evening.
Thank you, Lizette. No longer being the mayor, you're relegated to the role to read letters of politicians who can't make it to worthy events like this. I still feel blessed, but I have to say this. You give a former mayor a microphone, he's not only going to read the letter, but he will say a couple of extra things. Very early in my term, I got to meet Dr. Ramos up at the State Department. And I encouraged Dr. Ramos to take the position with the Bridgeport Board of Education. Dr. Ramos has demonstrated time and time again, day in and day out and over the years, his dedication, his commitment, his passion for every single school child here in the city of Bridgeport. Dr. Ramos is true. Is truly, truly a man of substance. He has committed his entire life to educating children. And I have to say, I for one, am real sorry to see him leave. I wish he was still there. So rather than get into a whole lot of things, let me relegate myself back to the role that I'm here for, read this letter from Congressman Hines. And Jackie, let me also say this. Congratulations on pursuing your master's degree in divinity. I know you will do a phenomenal job. And I am praise and clear goal. I want to thank you for all the work that you have done for the Board of Education as well. Dear Dr. Ramos, I'm sorry that I cannot join you this evening to honor you and your achievement. I extend best wishes and congratulations on your tenure of service in the education of students in the Bridgeport Public Schools. Education is the key to a brighter future. The job of a teacher and a mentor is not only to help children develop the skills acquired and needed for success, but also to spur creativity, curiosity, and a love for learning. Your role as an instructional and effective leader in education has been well recognized. I don't have my glasses, I'm sorry, folks. Your work has prepared countless students for their future. And once again, congratulations on all that you have accomplished and best wishes on the success in your future endeavors. Dr. Ramos, I just want to say once again, Not only were you welcomed in Bridgeport, we look up to you, and I want to thank you personally as a former mayor and as one of, matter of fact, you're my boss now. I want to thank you for all the work that you've done here in Bridgeport. God bless you.
Okay, and our next speaker is our state representative from the 138th District, Mr. Andres Ayala Jr. And while he's reaching the podium, I just want to give a shout out to every attorney that's here from the law offices of Durant Nichols. Thank you for your continued support. Also, we have Associate Superintendent Mr. Robert Henry, Assistant Superintendent Terry Carroll, and Assistant Superintendent Denise Clemens. Thank you.
Good evening, everyone. It is an honor and a privilege to be here with you. And just to make a quick correction, I know that we've done redistricting and the lines have changed. I'm actually from the 128th District, which happens to be the Hollow and the east side of Bridgeport. But this evening, we're here to honor the work of Dr. Ramos. And when Dr. Ramos first came to the system, we heard the phrase, expect great things. He started his tenure here in Bridgeport with those expectations. As a teacher in the school system, as an elected official in the system, the city, I understand very clearly what the expectations are of people outside of Bridgeport, It's a reality, unfortunately. And it's a reality that we have to overcome. And that's why when Dr. Ramos first began and talked about expect great things, that was a tremendous shot in the arm, because we should not only be expecting great things from our students, we should be expecting the very best from everybody here in the city of Bridgeport. So Dr. Ramos, thank you for showing us what we can be. But this expectation doesn't stop tonight, it continues. Because we do expect great things, not only of the system, but I personally expect great things from you as well to continue that greatness, Dr. Ramos. Because it has been great work that you have done in the past. It's great work that you're doing today. And I know that it will be great things that you do in the near future. It's surprising when Dr. Ramos first came into the system and he was elected, he was nominated and chosen by the board. Many of my friends thankfully said, how'd you guys get that Puerto Rican in there? And I said, well, we worked real hard. We worked really hard. Dr. Ramos is one of us. Well, as time has gone on, folks knew and understood that Dr. Ramos is not Puerto Rican, actually Cape Verdean. But the great thing about Dr. Ramos is that, you know, there weren't any lines. He understood the needs of the Latino community. He understood the needs of the African-American community. He understood the needs of children in particular. So it wasn't about Latino, African-American, whites, or any of this. It was about what's in the best interest of our school children in our city. And I had that opportunity to work with Dr. Ramos in two capacities. One, obviously as my boss, teaching in the school system for 18 years, most of them at Bassett High School. And then through my work, first as a city councilman, next as president of the city council, and then lastly, where I'm at right now as state representative, chairman of the delegation of the state of Bridgeport. And the work that we've done, it's been amazing to work with Dr. Ramos. I know that in many of the different groups that have been formed and the work that we've done to make sure that we work on the mission, that we work on everything that's important to ensure that the school system runs. I think one of the things that really spoke to me about the character of Dr. Ramos and about what his mission was, oftentimes working with superintendents put together these high-powered groups
looking for elected officials, looking for the business community to be a part of these organizations. But I succinctly remember Dr. Ramos making sure that we had all of the stakeholders involved in all of the work of the BOE. And he made sure that individuals from the nonprofit organizations that service our great city, that they were sitting at the table. He made sure that elected officials from state and local level and parents were part of every task force, every organization, every group that he put together, because he got it. He understood that we needed everybody to be involved, to push in the right direction. So Dr. Ramos, I appreciate you for taking that lead and for doing what was right and making sure that it wasn't just the same people who sat around those tables to make decisions. You opened it up and made sure that everyone had a say. And I thank you for that. Lastly, and most importantly, what I'd like to say then, on behalf of the Bridgeport delegation, state reps and senators that work tirelessly with our Board of Education, with the administration to ensure that we can do right by the city, I just want to leave with two words, Dr. Ramos, and it's simply sometimes they're forgotten, or sometimes it's a little too late to mention them, and it's simply just thank you. Thank you.
Thank you all so much for coming. I know a lot of people traveled far away to get here. I also wanted to just think about the people in our family that aren't here and couldn't make it because they have work or other obligations, or those who have passed away in our family. Let's just keep those in our minds and our prayers today. Thank you again. Thank you everyone for coming. I also want to give a special thank you to my grandmother and grandfather. Also want to thank my auntie Lynn for doing a tremendous amount of work for me today. Auntie Lynn. Stand up, Auntie Lynn, please. She doesn't get the credit she deserves. I'm telling you. All right. And lastly, I want to thank the staff alone for putting this together.
Thank you all for coming from the bottom of my heart on behalf of the Ramos family.
really appreciate your continued support. We really appreciate you coming here. Dr. Cooper, I see you right in front of me, the President and CEO of the National Urban Alliance. Thank you for coming as well. All right, it's party time and child time. Dr. Ramos, do you want to say something though before I close?
Yes.
And if I
know it? All I have to do is look around me. Look at you. Look at you. Look what God made. Now look what He brought together in this world. You could be anywhere. It's Christmas time. You could be anywhere. But you're here. I feel so blessed. Do me a favor. Just do me a favor. I know that Sal is in the way and all that, but just do me a favor. There's so many people in here that I want to meet each other, right? I mean, there are a whole lot of my best friends in this room. And I'm thinking, I always wanted her to meet him, him to meet her. And like, so just do me a favor. You know, just like, you know, Father Von Arx is here from Fairfield University, the president of Fairfield University. Father, forgive me, I'm going to take one out of your page. I want you all to pass the peace. All right? So stand up. Just stand up. Reach out to somebody you have not met yet. If it means you have to cross this dance floor to do it, go ahead and do it. And pass the peace.
Thank you. arrive is none other than U.S. Senator Richard Blumenthal.
Proud and honored to be here tonight, and I want to tell you why. First of all, I should just tell you, I'm still the junior senator from Connecticut. I'm the junior senator. Among the 100 senators, you know there are 100, in seniority, I am number 97. So I'm glad you're laughing. Any day I get a chance to say something is a good day for me. It's like being the new teacher in the class, in the school. But I am really sincerely honored to be here tonight. First, I mean very, very honestly and seriously, no mayor in the United States of America is more committed to education than William Finch. Bill Finch is there for the children of Bridgeport, and he's fighting for them and for the children of Connecticut. But most important, I'm here to congratulate and thank a guy I've known for a lot of years, a guy I've admired and watched in the trenches of education, in the schools of Watertown and Norwalk, in the Department of Education, and now in Bridgeport. He has been relentless and tireless in trying to make our schools worthy of the future of our children. In the United States Senate, I sit on a committee called Health Education, Labor and Pensions. I also sit on Armed Services and Judiciary, and we have just finished marking up, which means rewriting the bill to replace No Child Left Behind, to reauthorize the Elementary and Secondary Education Act. And we're going to continue fighting for a better federal law that will help cities, urban areas, major educational systems like Bridgeport, because they need it. But the person whose idea and leadership has been a model is John Ramos. John Ramos. Been there for children his whole life, is dedicated to this cause. And I told John tonight, whatever he decides to do next, I want him to be a partner and an ally in Washington as we go forward fighting this battle there. And we're going to make it. I want to thank his wife, Jacqueline, who, you know, many of us know we're only as good as, you know, our spouse. And I want to say thank you to Jacqueline for letting him do the great work that he's done, supporting him, not just letting him, but supporting him in that work. A great, great thank you to Jacqueline. And let me just say finally, I want to present to Mr. Ramos. I can't call him John because, you know, there are probably some of his students here. To John, I want to present to Dr. John Ramos a certificate of special recognition from the Senate of the United States. And some of you may not think that the United States Senate is doing all that much these days, but we got this done. Bipartisan. Come on up now. You just want to get a picture. I want to say, you know, there are a lot of educators in this room, who have devoted their lives to teaching and curriculum and improving the diversity and eliminating the gap. I don't need to give anybody here a lecture, because you know a lot more about than I do. To the teachers of Connecticut, to the educators of Bridgeport, our state and our nation, I want to say thank you. Thank you for the great work you do. You are never thanked enough. Thank you for having a great evening. Thank you for being here tonight. Thank you.
Dr. Ramos's father would like to say a few words.
Okay? Ladies and gentlemen, ladies and gentlemen, I'm not accustomed to public speaking, I was a bad boy you heard about all your life, but some good things happened to me in my life. Something that I'm very proud of that happened to me in my life was my son, John Ramos. I'm not accustomed to public speaking, like I said, but there's one little story I want to share with you. If you'll allow me, tell you a story about a time 50 years ago when I was working in a steel mill during the night hours, and during the day hours I was out painting houses because I was trying to buy a house for my wife and kids. My son John was 9 at the time, and I said to myself, well, I got a partner, so I'm going to teach him how to handle a paintbrush. And I put him in a particular area of the house, left him with a paintbrush in his hand and a can of paint, and I came back 2 hours later, and John had painted a 12-inch square. I wasn't too happy about that. So I snatched the brush from him and I told him, get lost, pal. You can't help me. And would you believe that his dear mother, Joan, who was sitting right here to my right, said to me, well, don't be so hard on the kid. Maybe he's not cut out for that kind of thing. 10 minutes later, I went to check on my son, Jan, and he was laying on his bunk bed reading a book. What does that tell you? Hey, you see the magic in that? Look where he's at today. And look what he's accomplished. And look what he's done for the thousands of kids that probably couldn't handle a paintbrush. Right, John? I love you, man. I wish you the best. You know, I'm behind you 100%. Your mom's behind you 100%. And more important than anything, because of your sincerity and your true belief, your God is behind you. Don't you ever forget. Thank you, people.
with your encouragement, and I came to Bridgeport. It's been exciting as well as a learning experience for me. I look forward to my continued growth. When I take this opportunity to focus on you, I wish you well, and you continue to grow and reach your new heights. May God continue to bless you as He has always done, and keep you in His love and care. Take care, God bless.
So, Ramos, it's been a pleasure. Just think of it, no more Friday pop-ups for me. Enjoy your retirement.
For sure.
Dr. John Ramos and family, you've been such an inspiration to me. I'm so proud to know you and just feel truly blessed. Please continue to do the work that God's called you to do. And thank you for allowing me to get to know you and your family. God bless you.
Uncle John, this is Hadu Chernet from the Chernet family. Just wanted to say thank you for everything that you've done for our people. You're a great mentor, great father, great husband to your wife, and one of the best guys I know, man. Love you. Cheers.
Beautiful soulless. Come on, let's rock out with this young lady. Miss Alda Grown. Get down on it. 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 Get down on it.
than me. I've had a lovely career at teaching at Lewis Murray School, eighth grade math teacher. I love all the children in Bridgeport. Thank you again. I will miss you. Love, Lisa Perillo.
Mr. Ramos is a very intelligent, from his growing up, where he came from, and his background, everything is a beautiful, exciting a moment to just be around him so he can inspire people like he did to me. I love John Ramos like that. John Ramos is a captain to me. He's a doctor. He's a person in my life that I really care about. I love John Ramos.
All right. Here, I got one. Here's to you, Kuzi. To that I say, viva. Viva, viva, salud.
Oh, speak. No, John Ramos and I go so far back, and I have two words for him. He's gonna love it. I got two words for him. John Lennon.